There's a secret treasure room in Liu Wen Hui's mansion. And what's so special about the local wedding customs here that date back some 600 years? You are watching Anren, Town of Mansions. No one had any idea that behind this wall in the Liu mansion, there was a 576 cubic meter treasure vault. Building it took 6 years, from 1938 to 1944.
金库啊，有三道梯门，我们进里面去看看。进了这个第二道梯门啊，这个就是它的这个藏经室了。开了第三道梯门，里面也是它的藏经室。据说这个在这间金库啊，当年藏了很多的这个字画、金银珠宝、玛瑙、翡翠，据说藏了这个黄金有600多万两。
But why did they build a secret treasure vault here? And how was it discovered? Anren, located in Dayi County, Sichuan Province, has a history of over 1,000 years. The town's most important cultural edifices include the Liu Mansion and three old streets, all of which are in an excellent state of preservation. In the Republic of China era, mansions were symbols of power and wealth. When referring to this period, it's hard not to mention the Sichuan warlords. And when speaking of them, it's difficult to avoid referring to the Liu family. The Liu clan and their affiliates built more than 50 mansions in Anren, 27 of which have been preserved to the present day. But why did they build mansions here?
1945年以后才形成的这条街道，在这条街道就有大大小小的有8个公馆，比如说这个就是刘元轩的公馆，是吧？这个刘元轩的公馆。 刘元轩24院的是24军的代军长，是吧？前面那个是陈玉生的公馆，陈玉生院的是24军的一个军区处长。这一个公馆是院那个刘体中的公馆，刘体中也是24军的一个团长。Today,
this building is the Anren Mansion Club, but it was formerly the mansion of Chen Yuesheng, who was head of supplies of the 136th Division of the Kuomintang's 24th Army. The mansion combines elements of Chinese and Western styles.
It's not just a Chinese, it's also a Chinese. 重现那个古镇的一个辉煌，是在民国时间，所以民国时期啊，他刘氏家族啊，这个重新的崛起了。他这个家刘氏家族当中有3个军长，其中有2个担任了省主席，他们一些亲戚啊，安仁镇的一些人啊，都带出去升当官了。所以这些人啊，都是随着刘家出去升官发财回来了以后，再修的这么一些公馆。This
is the Liu Mansion, which is particularly well preserved. It consists of 5 mansions. As for the old Ford parked in front of the museum, Wu Hongyuan tells us that Liu Wencai built a 20-kilometer road from Xinjin County in Chengdu to Anren just so he could bring it home. Liu Wenhui's mansion covers about 25,000 square meters and has the Liu mansion's most distinctive architecture. Built between 1938 and 1941, it has three courtyards. Liu Wenhui was the commander of the Kuomintang's 24th Army and also the governor of both Sichuan and Xikang provinces. After the liberation in 1949, he served as the Minister of Forestry. This tall gate combines various Chinese and Western architectural styles. Above the door hangs a tablet with four Chinese characters and some script in Tibetan. The Chinese characters say, "Cultivate moral character and seek to achieve," while the Tibetan script reads, "Palace of Power." The gate is decorated with lifelike carvings of animals. The reporter meets up with Ji Fujian, an expert in the architecture of southwestern China. In his mansion, Although the treasure vault was hidden and well reinforced, it was discovered all the same. When the Kuomintang general Hu Zongnan turned up at the mansion, it was sacked by his soldiers and they found it. Liu's allies did their best to match the luxuriousness of the Liu mansion. So how does the mansion of another army officer, Gao Mingxuan, compare?
咱们这里公馆体现就是非常有个性，每一家就不同。哦，从空间上头可以判断每一个人的地位，是吧？每个人的境界能力，每个人的文化素质。Gao
Mingxuan's mansion, which is in the traditional local style, was built in 1945. Although it isn't as luxurious as the Liu mansion, it has a number of unique features. While the owners of these mansions are long gone, in their time, they apparently had some influence on local wedding customs. Why is there a sword attached to this bridal sedan chair? What does throwing chopsticks signify? Which dishes were popular with the powerful Liu clan? This is Anren, town of mansions. Along the streets of Anren, shops selling wedding supplies can be found just about everywhere. Such is the importance of weddings here that every month there are two wedding fairs. And as it happens, their crew is here just in time to attend one of them. The wedding customs of Anren are derived from those that were already common in the Ming Dynasty and had their heyday during the Republic of China era. For the wedding feast of Liu Wen Cai's son, there were hundreds of invited guests, and the feast lasted for 3 days and nights. These are items used at the weddings of children of the Liu family. These are the bride's three necessities: the box of treasures, a sword decorated with 108 coins, and chopsticks. These customs have been preserved right up to the present day. Throwing chopsticks in Anren dialect sounds the same as giving birth to a son, and it implies hope of a happy life.
这个程序，男方有20几个程序，比如说像我们这儿这个女方的程序呢，有烧亲丢筷子，啊，其中筷子我们的花轿和挂个宝剑，包括宝剑呢，哦，宝剑呢是新娘到新郎家路上遇到不吉利的事情啊，哦，一种避喜，取水的一种意思，它这个宝剑也是还有种含义呢，它上面挂的有铜钱，一般呢一般有几个。 多的呢有100多个，它是一直用过明白，哦，有钱有势，哦，这种意思。安人呢，我们以前安人刘氏家族，他们举行的婚礼都是用的这种形式，一直保存到今天。
In addition to the wedding customs, dishes created by the Liu family are greatly favored among locals. These dishes are only served at this restaurant when there's a wedding banquet. The crew learns of a chef named Liao Hongguang, whose grandfather was the Liu family cook. Liao agrees to cook some of the secret Liu family dishes. The Liu family was famous for their love of food. One of their renowned delicacies is known as landlord's spare ribs.
This is
The next dish, said to have been Liu Wencai's favorite, is manchun braised pork in brown sauce. First, the skin is roasted and hair removed to ensure the best taste. Next, cut the pork into thick pieces and blanched in water. After that comes the most important part, the broth. First, some rock sugar is fried. Although rock sugar is common today, in the Republic of China period, it was scarce and expensive. It often had to be imported, so when transportation difficulties and associated costs were factored in, only the very wealthy could afford it. Yu Qing duck feet, a favorite among the mansion's concubines, is quite a sophisticated dish. Fresh duck feet are deboned and served cold. It was named after Liu Wencai's fifth concubine, Wang Yu Qing, who racked her brains to come up with a dish she hoped would please Liu. In the old streets of Anren, these dishes handed down from the mansions mean good business. Today, many of the old mansions feature signs that read museum, restaurant, or hotel. But what have these changes brought to locals of Anren? Why have mansions become museums? Why does Fan Jian Chuan attend to set up the country's biggest cluster of museums in the town of Anren? This is Anren, town of mansions. The mansions of Anren are not only well preserved, today they serve as shops opened by the descendants of the original owners. Some mansions have been converted into stores, but most of them are now museums open for visitors. Today, Liu Yuan Tang's mansion is a museum where one can watch one Chinese classic film every day. At the museum, Cao Guimin tells us that the museum has a collection of more than 5,000 films. It also has film tickets, posters, and film reels from the Republic of China era. And it even has China's earliest film projector. But why did Cao Guimin choose the town of Anren as the place in which to set up this classic film museum. As well as the mansion's museums, Anren also houses Jianchuan Museum, China's biggest museum cluster. The curator of the museum, Fan Jianchuan, is a native of Sichuan, and he's also a collector, researcher, and writer of Chinese history. He shows us around the Mansion Furniture Museum. Fan has invested most of his earnings from his years in the real estate industry in these museums, which comprise 21 individual museums, housing a collection of around 7 million pieces. Why did he devote himself to establishing the museums in Anren? Before he bought this place, Fan spent a long time trying to decide just where he could put all his collections. So why did he settle on Anren?
Why did he settle on Anren? 这是第一。第二，我特别喜欢安仁，是安仁没有工业，它是个历史文化名镇，它没有工业，没有污染，特别好，感觉特别好。所以我就觉得安仁镇是最适合我在这儿安家落户的。事实证明，确实好，确实好。安仁本身也有文化，刘文才、刘文辉啊、刘湘啊这些人在这儿。Today,
Anren has not only its well-preserved mansions, but also China's biggest museum cluster. These features combined make Anren a genuine museum town in China. The glory of the past may have passed, but memories of those illustrious bygone days and the mansions of the era remain. Today, the residents of this town are writing a new chapter in a long and memorable history.